Hello students, in the last class we have discussed production of cast iron from cupola, and in the previous sessions before that what we have discussed extraction metallurgy, different types of extraction metallurgy, and how the metals are extracted from their ores, and we have discussed the construction details and operation of a blast furnace. And what is the charge and what are the products of a blast furnace we have discussed. So the pig iron is the product of blast furnace, and we have studied the what is pig iron and why we have to refine it, that pig iron, because it is not suitable for industrial applications, its mechanical properties are inferior. All these things we have discussed in the previous sessions, and along with that also we have discussed the production of wrought iron from a puddling furnace. So pig iron is not suitable for industrial applications. So what we are doing, we are refining the properties of pig iron in a puddling furnace, and we are getting wrought iron. The wrought iron is the purest form of iron, and which is used in many industries for different applications. And later we have discussed in the previous session, that is production of cast iron from cupola. So in that one we have discussed what is the charge for cupola and what is the product, that means how you are going to get this cast iron from this cupola. All these things we have discussed, and we have discussed the constructional details of a cupola furnace and the operation details of a cupola furnace, and the various reactions that took place in the cupola furnace also we have discussed, and we have discussed the charge, what is the charge for cupola furnace. All these things we have discussed in the previous session, and today what we are going to discuss manufacturing of steel by Bessemer process. Okay, so till now we have discussed the production of iron, that is pig iron, wrought iron and cast iron by different methods. So the pig iron is produced from blast furnace, and your wrought iron is produced from puddling furnace, and your cast iron is produced from cupola furnace. So here we have studied the charge, the constructional details and the operations and the reactions and the products that can be obtained from the processes, and the properties and the applications of the products. All these things are discussed in the previous sessions. Today what we are going to discuss steels. I already told you when we can say steel and when we can say cast iron. These things we will learn in the coming sessions, iron equilibrium diagram, iron carbon equilibrium diagram. So in that iron carbon equilibrium diagram, so iron and carbon, so based on the percentage of carbon we can say that steel, and we can say that cast iron. So the percentage of carbon varies in steels and your cast iron. Those things we will discuss in detail in the coming sessions, that is iron carbon equilibrium diagram. But here we are mostly interested in the production of iron and steel. Okay, so here what we are going to discuss the manufacture of steel by Bessemer process. In this Bessemer process, if you see the Bessemer process, so before that, before going into entering into the actual process, we will see what we have discussed in the previous session once again as a review. See here, these things we have studied. See, manufacture of pig iron by using blast furnace, just now I have discussed, and manufacturing of wrought iron in puddling furnace, manufacturing of cast iron in cupola. So these things we have discussed in the previous session. So, and what are the properties of wrought iron and what are the properties of this cast iron and how they are used in different applications, these things we have discussed elaborately in the previous sessions. Now we are going to discuss manufacture of steel by acid Bessemer process and manufacturing of steel by Basir Bessemer process and principle of operation and Bessemer converter process. These things we are going to discuss. Okay, so if you go for the introduction, if you go for the introduction process, so how a Bessemer process, so who invented this Bessemer process, these things, that means the history of the Bessemer process we will see here. If you see here, okay, this is for understanding purpose. See, Henry Bessemer, so he is the one of the, that means Bessemer is the name of a person. That means Henry Bessemer is a person, is a scientist, we can say, of England, discovered this Bessemer process in 1856. So it is an old process. So in 1856, this Henry Bessemer of England discovered this one, this your Bessemer process. So process consists of refining malt and pig iron in a converter. So already we know that pig iron is not suitable for industrial applications. So what we are doing here, we are refining the pig iron in a converter to get, it can be used in different applications. That means the property can be improved. So different properties of the pig iron can be improved by refining it in a converter, and in that way we are going to get steel. So he invented this one in the 1856. He belongs to England, and Bessemer converter is a pear-shaped furnace about 6 meters high and 3 meters diameter. If you see here, pear, it is a fruit name. So pear, so it's look like a pear shape. That means the shape of the converter like a pear. So pear is nothing but it's a fruit, you know, right? So in that shape, your Bessemer converter will be there. And it is high of 6 meters, and diameter will be 3 meters, and its capacity ranges from 10 to 25 tons of charge at a time. Okay, so its capacity will be 10 to 25 tons. So a minimum 10 tons and maximum 25 tons, and its diameter is 3 meters and height is 6 meters. So this is the general introduction of a Bessemer converter. Okay, so he is the inventor of this Bessemer converter. So he invented the Bessemer converter in 1856, and he belongs to England. And what we are going to do in a Bessemer converter, what we are going to do, we are refining the malt and pig iron to get the properties can be improved, so such that it can be used for the industrial applications. And it is a pear shaped furnace and of 6 meters high and 3 meters width, that means diameter, and its capacity ranges from 10 to 25 tons of charge at a time. So this is the introduction of a Bessemer converter. And if we go for the next one, see, so the converter is lined with high refractory material. So already we have discussed what is meant by high refractory material, right? So if you see what is meant by high refractory material, so first we have to understand what is meant by refractory material. A material which can able to withstand high temperatures, that is known as refractory material. So here the converter is lined with refractory material such that the temperature that can be developed inside the converter, that can be the liner should able to withstand the temperature. Okay, so that's why we have to line the inside of the converter with high refractory material, which is having high refractoriness, and it consists of three parts. If you observe the diagram of a Bessemer converter, it will be having a detachable bottom. You are having a detachable bottom, and you are having central cylindrical portion. And next, upper conical portion, generally which is in eccentric. Okay, see here. So these are the three main parts: detachable bottom, central cylindrical portion, and upper conical portion, generally eccentric. So these are the three parts of a your Bessemer converter. And so how they can be useful and all those things we will see. See here. If you see here, you are having a detachable portion, you are having a conical, and here you are having a cylindrical. See here, what we have discussed, detachable bottom you are having, and you are having central cylindrical portion. If you see this one, I will show you. See here, if you see this one, it can be detached here. See this one. So this is the detached portion. And if you observe this one, this central portion, this is in cylindrical in nature. And if you see the top portion, how it will be, it is in conical shape. Okay. So these are the three parts of this Bessemer converter. Okay. So you are having detachable part at the bottom, and central one is cylindrical portion, and the top one is conical portion. So we are having three. So this is one, and this is two, and this is three. So 1, 2, 3 we are having. So these three are the parts of a Bessemer converter. So here, if you see, in this Bessemer converter, already what we have discussed, if you see here, you are having lining. This is the shell, outer shell. See, these are for rotating purpose you are having here, this one. And from here you are sending the air. So this is the air blast pipe. And here also we are sending air. And this is the tires for sending the air blast. So this is a Bessemer converter. So this is the construction details of a Bessemer converter. See this one. So this is your slag. If you see, this is your slag, and you are having molten trays here, and air blast is from there. So these are the tires that are used for producing this, for supplying up for this air. So next, very, very important is, here we are having two types of Bessemer converters, acid Bessemer process and basic Bessemer process. So what is the difference and how the process will be in acid Bessemer as well as in basic Bessemer, we will discuss here. So first one is, we are taking acid Bessemer process. So what is acid Bessemer process? Steel is made from pig iron by oxidizing the impurities. So how we are going to do? So how you are going to manufacturing the steel? That means steel is made from pig iron, already we know that. So how? By oxidizing the impurities. See here, when we take the pig iron, what is the drawback of that pig iron? Pig iron is not having sufficient properties that can be used for the industrial applications. So what we have to do, we have to remove those impurities and we have to improve the properties such that it can be useful for the industrial applications. So for such that, what we are going to do, we are oxidizing the impurities in a converter and we are going to get steel. So how the things will be happen, we will discuss. But here, so first we have to remember how you are going to get the steel. You are going to get the steel by oxidizing the impurities that are present in the pig iron. And next, so here if we are taking the acid Bessemer process. So acid Bessemer process, furnace is made of acid refractories. So this is important. In acid Bessemer process, so the lining, the furnace lining will be generally made with acid refractories. Generally, we can use silica bricks or fine clay. Silica bricks or fine clay. Okay, so these are the few important points to note here. Those are, so steel is made from pig iron by oxidizing the impurities that are present in the pig iron. And if you go for the acid Bessemer process, because we are having two Bessemer process, acid Bessemer and basic Bessemer process. So furnace is made of acid Bessemer process. It is lined with acid refractories such as silica bricks or fine clay. So these are the three points you have to remember in the acid Bessemer process. And if you go for basic Bessemer process, if you see the in the basic Bessemer process, sulfur and sulfur phosphorus besides other impurities are removed. Okay, so here we can remove sulfur and phosphorus. Sulfur and phosphorus can be removed in the basic Bessemer process. So in the basic Bessemer process, the basic Bessemer process, we are going to remove the sulfur and phosphorus besides other impurities. So along with other impurities, we are going to remove this basic Bessemer in the basic Bessemer process. What we are going to remove? We are going to remove sulfur and phosphorus in addition to other impurities. And the converter is lined with dolomite or magnesite. Okay, there fine clay and silica bricks. Fine clay or silica bricks, but here dolomite or magnesite. So which is a brick basic refractory material. So the lining will be with basic refractory material, that is dolomite and magnesite. Magnesite should be used here in basic Bessemer process. And if you go for the charge, see here. So this is the charge, molten pig iron you are taking and cold steel scrap we can add, and you are going to get slag. Okay, that the impurities can be removed in the form of slag. Okay, so this is the charge and principle. If you see the principle, how the principle will be, if you see the principle, this is very very important. Generally for every furnace you should understand the principle. Without understanding the principle, we are unable to know what we are going to do. If you see here in the principle, so both acid and Bessemer process are operated in a basic converter. Whether you take acid process or a basic process, both can be operated in a Bessemer converter. But only thing is, you have to change the lining. That means refractory lining material should be changed, because in acid Bessemer converter you have to use acidic lining, whereas in basic Bessemer process you have to use basic line refractory material. So here you can be used dolomite or magnesite. In acidic process you can use fine clay or silica bricks. And production of steel involves, so what we are going to, how the steel can be produced. So we know that general how the steel can be produced, we already just now we have discussed. We are removing the impurities that are present in the pig iron by oxidizing the impurities that are present in the pig iron. So we are removing the impurities, we are removing the impurities from the from that one pig iron, and those are useful for industrial applications. That means the properties can be improved, and those are useful for industrial applications. So the removal of undesirable impurities, that means the impurities are not desirable. So the removal of undesirable impurities is take place, and the carbon content comes down to a specified value. That means here I already told you, here if you see here what I told you, the carbon content comes to a specified value. I already told you that based on the carbon content we can say cast irons and we can say steel. That means the classification of steels and cast irons can be done based on the percentage of carbon present. So that's why we should maintain the carbon content in such a way that it should act as a steel. That means based on the carbon content only we can classify cast irons as well as steels. So we have to maintain the carbon percentage as well as addition of alloying elements. So if you want to improve, any mechanical properties in addition, that is special characteristics, special properties, then you can add some other alloying elements into that one such that those properties can be improved. I am repeating once again, what is the principle and what are the stages involved here? Whether if you take acid Bessemer process or basic Bessemer process, both can be done in a Bessemer converter. But the only thing is, you have to use the converter lining. That means Bessemer converter lining. If you use acid Bessemer process, then you have to use acidic refractory lining. And if you want to use basic Bessemer process, you have to use basic refractory lining. So for acid, you can use silica bricks or fine clay. For basic Bessemer process, you can use either dolomite or magnesite. And production of steel involves. So we are having these three stages. So the first one and the second one are very, very important. And this is optional. That means if you need some strength, if you need some other properties should be improved, then we have to add this alloying element. So first, what we have to do? We have to remove the impurities that are not desirable and which drags the the mechanical properties are inferior. Those things should be removed. So for that one, what we are doing, we are removing the removal of undesirable impurities. So those impurities that are not useful, those can be removed off. And later the carbon content, I already told you that cast iron and steels are classified based on the carbon content. So you have to maintain the carbon content to certain level. And the addition of alloying elements, if you need more properties, that means if you want to improve certain properties, then you have to add some alloying elements. So this is the principle of producing steel from Bessemer converter. See what will happen. Bessemer converter. So refining molten pig iron in a converter. Refining molten pig iron in a converter, just now we have discussed, body of converter is made of steel plate and is lined with silica bricks. Okay, so silica bricks means if it is acidic and the top of the converter is open and the bottom contains tires and wind box. So just now I showed you the diagram. So you are having tires for a supply of air, this is your tires and wind box for supply of air, and a hollow pivot enables the converter to be rotated in three positions. So it can be rotated in three positions. Okay, so you are having a pivot arrangement, hollow pivot arrangement, so such that it can be rotated in three positions. That means loading and operation and unloading. So it can be rotated in three positions. I will show you the different positions also. So these are the constructional details. So Bessemer process. If you see the Bessemer process, molten pig iron from the blast furnace is charged into the Bessemer converter in the charging position. Okay. These are very, very important. See here, molten pig iron from blast furnace. So we know that pig iron is produced from blast furnace. So that pig iron can be used as a charge into the Bessemer converter, and that position is known as charging position. This is the charging position. And oxidation of impurities of molten pig iron through cold air blown under high pressure in a small stream through the bath of molten iron, that is slowing position. So what we are doing? So this is the first step. And in the second step, what we are going to do, we are going for the oxidation of the impurities by the supply of air, by supply of cold air under high pressure in small streams through the bath of molten iron. So into the molten iron, what we are going to do, we are sending the air blast. Because of that one, you are going to get the impurities can be oxidized. So that position is known as slowing position. And after the decarburization, that means after maintaining the required level of carbon percentage, then the flame drops and the steel is tapped. So based on the flame, by maintaining the carbon percentage, and we can say that the required the required steel, the required properties, the steel which is having required properties is ready, then what we have to do? We have to pour it for solidification. Okay, so that is a third position, that is puring position. So what are the three positions we are having? Charging position, slowing position, and puring position. So first one, what we have to do? We have to take the molten pig iron from the blast furnace and it can be charged into the Bessemer converter, that is charging position. And after charging the Bessemer converter, what we have to do? We have to supply cold air with high pressure through the baths of the molten metal. So what will happen? So the impurities can be oxidized and it can be removed off. So that is slowing position. That means removal of impurities will take place. And the third one, we have to maintain required amount of carbon percentage. For that one, so we have to go for the decarburization process. That means we are maintaining the carbon percentage as per requirement. So based on that one, after getting required percentage of carbon, that steel with the required properties is ready for puring, for solidification. So then we can pure it into the ladles and it can be go for the solidification process. So these are the steps involved in the Bessemer process. And if you go for the, see this one, Bessemer converter, this is a Bessemer converter here. See, we have discussed three positions of a Bessemer converter here. If you see, this is the charging position. So here from pig iron, from here, what we are doing, we are sending the pig iron, that means we are charging the pig iron into the Bessemer converter. So this is the charging position. And later, this is the slowing position. So if you see the slowing position, in the slowing position, from here to here, what we are doing, we are sending the air blast. See, you are sending the air blast through this air. This is your molten bath, molten metal bath, that is molten pig iron. So through this, what you are sending? You are sending cold and high pressure air. So because of that one, that impurities that are present in the pig iron, that can be oxidized and they can be removed in the form of slag later. And if you see here, after completion of this one, what we are having, we have to remove, that means we have to collect the steel that is obtained. So before that one, what we have to do? Before emptying it, what we have to do? We have to decarburize it. Decarburize means if the carbon percentage is more, then we have to remove that additional carbon. Required amount of carbon should be maintained in the steel. So such that here we have to go for the, that is third position, that is decarburization of the, here this is third position. So this is the third one and this is the second one and this is the first one. So first one is charging position and second one is slowing position and the third one is the puring position. So what, after decarburization, after maintaining required amount of carbon, what we have to do? We have to pour it into different ladles and that can be sent to the solidification process. So here in the third stage, it will be happen. So here what we are doing, we are emptying the Bessemer converter. Here we are charging and here we are slowing position. That means we are having the impurities we can be oxidized and they can be removed. Here after decarburization, we are removing the steel. That means we are emptying the steel and we are pouring the steel into the ladles and that can be sent to the solidification process. See here, if you see here, this is actual Bessemer converter. If you see here, you are having a detachable portion, this is the bottom portion, and here if you observe the central portion, this one, this is a cylindrical shape, and if you see the top portion, this is the conical shape. So we have discussed the construction details of a Bessemer converter. In that one, if you see, these are the three sections we are having, and it can be rotated. If you see this arrangement, if you see this arrangement, it can be rotated in three positions. That can be, first one is charging position, and the second one is slowing position, and the third one is, what is the third one? That is pouring position. After decarburation, after getting steel ready, it can be tapped for a further solidification process. So these are the, this is the actual, that means in a real time, how a Bessemer converter will look like. So the height will be generally 6 meters, and the diameter will be around 3 meters, and the shape is a pear. So it is a pear shape. It is a pear shape. Okay. So this is the construction of a, this is the construction of a Bessemer converter. See here, Bessemer converter. Okay. For understanding purpose, they have given for sending the air blast. So how we are sending the air blast here? See, if you see the cross section. So this is very, very important. It is look like a pear shape. If you observe this cross section. See here, if you observe this one, this is a detachable portion, and this is cylindrical portion, and this is conical portion. And if you see this shape, so how it will be, it like a pear shape. It's a fruit, pear shape. Okay, so that is the shape of a Bessemer converter, and we are having this arrangement for rotating purpose. It can be rotated in three directions, in the three positions, sorry, in, it can be rotated in three positions. See here, this is important. Steel is produced by oxidizing impurities and carbon by blowing air through molten pig iron. So carbon means we are stabilizing. That means we require some amount of carbon. So that much carbon is required. So if any additional carbon is there, that should be oxidized. Along with impurities, the carbon is also oxidized. And in a converter, charging position, lowering molten pig iron just below the tires level. So in a converter, what we have to do? First, we have to go for the charging position and lowering the molten pig iron just below the tires level, and later rotate into right up position. That means if you see the, so initially it will be like that. So it can be charged and it can be rotated like this. And later we have to send the air blast. See here, you have to send the air blast. And at a pressure of 2 to 2.5 atmospheres, the air blast eliminates impurities and carbon. That means it decarburizes as well as the impurities can be removed. So this is the process that will takes place in a Bessemer converter. Okay, before that I will show you, see. So whatever we have discussed here, the diagram represents the stages that are involved. Okay, so already we know that if you see this one, it is very easy to understand. See, this is your bottom portion. So actually the Bessemer converter should be like this, but while charging, how it will look How it will become? It will become like this. So you will charge here. Here you are charging. In this way you are charging. After charging, what is happening? So it is becoming like this. So it is becoming straight, vertical. It is becoming vertical. So here, after becoming, after making it upright, that is vertical, we have to send air blast from here. We have to send air blast from here. Okay. And after the impurities and the carbon, that means impurities can be removed and the carbon can be stabilized. Stabilized in the sense, so how much carbon is required, that amount of carbon should be present in that steel. So if any additional carbon is there, that should be decarburized. That means that carbon should be removed off. So after doing that, what we have to do? We have to pour it. Okay. So these two stages. So the two stages we have discussed just now. And what are the reactions that will take place? We will discuss now. Okay. See, I will show you. So these things what we have discussed. So we are charging the molten metal into the Bessemer converter. Okay. And later it is rotated into upright position. And air blast is forced through a tires at a pressure of 2 to 2.5 atmospheres. And because of this air, what will happen? Impurities and carbon can get oxidized. And what are the reactions will take place? If you see the reactions, see, oxygen or air blast oxidizes iron into iron oxide. And iron oxide reacts with impurities like silicon, manganese and carbon. And if you see here, these are the reactions. Because of that, oxidation of impurities provides necessary heat for the process, and silicon and manganese are oxidized and form slag. So in this way, these impurities can be removed off. So in this way, those impurities can be removed. Okay. So these are the reactions. First reaction, iron becomes iron oxide. Later, this iron oxide reacts with impurities and your slag will be formed, and the slag can be removed off. And the necessary heat for these reactions can be done with the oxidation of the impurities. And if you go further, basic Bessemer process. So high phosphorus pig iron is charged into the converter. So if the phosphorus content is more and silicon and manganese or carbon are oxidized first, then phosphorus is oxidized. First, these are removed and later phosphorus can be oxidized. So these are the reactions that supports the reaction. Oxidation process, and slag is poured off into the slag ladle before adding deoxidizers and carburizers. Okay, so if any that means at the end you have to add deoxidizers and recarburizers if any carbon content falls below the required amount, then you have to add recarburizers and deoxidizers. Okay, so first these silicon, manganese and carbon are oxidized. Later phosphorus will be oxidized in the basic Bessemer process. So this is very, very important. What is the difference between acid Bessemer process and basic Bessemer process? So this is very, very important. Difference between acid Bessemer process and basic Bessemer process. So if you see the acid Bessemer process and basic Bessemer process, the first one is, converter is lined with acid refractory materials such as silica bricks or fine clay. So first one, we have to remember that the lining, the refractory lining is different. That means for acidic Bessemer process, you have to line the inside of the Bessemer converter with acidic refractory material. Whereas in basic Bessemer process, you have to line the, you have to go for the basic refractory lining. That means if you see here, converter lined with basic refractory material such as dolomite or magnesite. So you have to use dolomite or magnesite for lining process. And if you see, the slag is acidic and the slag is basic. So whatever the slag that forms because of these impurities, that is acidic in nature, and here basic in nature. So second, so for acidic, acidic, for basic, basic, and here acidic, the lining should be acidic. For the basic, the lining should be basic. So similar, right? So but you should remember this is silica bricks and fine clay here examples, and here dolomite and magnesite are the examples you should remember. And eliminates silica and manganese only. So in this one, only we can remove these two impurities, that is silica and manganese, but removes sulfur and phosphorus also. If you want to remove, that means in addition to silica and manganese, if you want to remove sulfur and phosphorus, then you have to go for basic Bessemer process. Basic Bessemer process, that means in basic Bessemer process, not only silica and manganese can be removed, it is also removes the sulfur and phosphorus. So that's why if you want to, if it is your pig iron is having more content in sulfur and phosphorus, then we have to go for basic Bessemer process, because it removes silica as well as manganese. In that means in addition to the silica and manganese, it also removes sulfur and phosphorus. So that is the advantage. So this is the advantage of here your basic Bessemer process. Because of this one, so if you are having the sulfur and phosphorus as impurities, then you have to use this one. If you are not having sulfur and phosphorus as impurities, then you can use this acid Bessemer process. Okay, I'm repeating the 3 points again. If you see the 3 points, first one is lining. So for acidic Bessemer process, acidic refractory lining should be there with silica bricks or fine clay. And for basic, it should be basic refractory material such as dolomite or magnesite. And the formed slag is acidic in nature. And here the slag is basic in nature. And eliminates the silica and manganese only. Silicon and manganese only, but here it also eliminates sulfur and phosphorus in addition to silicon and manganese. See, heat requires is supplied by oxidation of silicon, requires longer blows. So here air blows are required for a longer time, because you are having sulfur and phosphorus that should be removed. Here, because of the silicon oxidation, the heat required can be supplied here, and suitable for rails, axles, springs, winds, screws, wires and screws, nuts and welded fuses. It is wires. So this is suitable for this process, and suitable for nuts, guinders and all kind of bridges and structural sections. Okay. So this is suitable for this type of applications. Okay. So the steel made by Bessemer process, basic Bessemer process, can be used for these applications. The steel that can be made from acid Bessemer process can be used for these applications. So these are the differences for acid Bessemer process and basic Bessemer process, and which is very, very important in the examination. So in the examination, they will ask what is the difference between acid Bessemer process and basic Bessemer process. And if you go for the summary, what we have discussed, see in the summary, if you see the summary, we have discussed manufacturing of steel by Bessemer converter, how the steel can be manufactured by using a Bessemer converter, and what is the construction of a Bessemer converter, and what is the principle and charge of a Bessemer converter, what are the different stages and different parts of a Bessemer converter we have discussed, and the principle of Bessemer converter. So what are the different three stages we are having in the principle of Bessemer converter? That means we have to remove the impurities that are present, and later we have to decarburize the carbon content to required level, and later we have to add some alloying elements if you require, some mechanical properties should be improved. And later we have discussed what is a basic Bessemer process and acid Bessemer process, and the difference between acid Bessemer and basic Bessemer process. If you go for some quiz, steel is made from pig iron. So from pig iron only we are making the steel. Basic Bessemer process is adopted when the pig iron contains rich in phosphorus. Okay, frequently asked questions will be, if you see, explain the principles of steel making in Bessemer converter. So how the steel can be made in a basic Bessemer converter, and explain the difference between acid Bessemer and basic Bessemer process. This is very, very important. If you see this, this one is very, very important. That means difference between acid Bessemer and basic Bessemer. So we are having few points, though few points we should write based on the marks. If it is asked for 5 marks, you have to maintain minimum 5 differences. Okay. So with this one, I'm closing today's session.